Hello, so this is a very last video wherein we are going to explore few more methods of pandas data frame. So let me go back to my notes. So the very first method we are going to see here is a replace method. Let me go back to the documentation and I will search for a replace method. Let me go very at the beginning and all right. Okay, so what it says is it replaces the value given in toReplace with value. So toReplace is one of the argument which we have to pass in a replace method. So as you can see here, toReplace is first argument. And what different types you can pass for this toReplace argument? One of the thing is dictionary. So as you can see here, dictionary can be used to specify different replacements, replacement values for different existing values. For example, so this is a dictionary they have passed. So what it says is it replaces the value A with B and Y with C. Okay, to use the dictionary in this way, the value parameter should be none. All right. So value parameter is this value parameter. That should be none. By default, it is none. So there are different examples they have mentioned over here. And we are not going to go through each and every example. But one important example which I want to show is this with regular expression. So let's check this guy. So over there, what they're doing is they're passing a dictionary, which we just saw, but with the help of regular expression. So let me go back to my data frame. So this is my data frame, which we have seen earlier. So now I want to change only in ID column, let's say anything which any particular value or record which starts with small a, I want to replace that with capital A. What I mean is, in this case, so the ID is AM Jadhav and I want to replace that with capital A, M, J, A, D, H, A, V. So I want to change that to init cap. How do I do that? So let me grab this data frame. I will call the replace method. All right. And I will copy this. So they are basically passing a dictionary, regular expression equal to dictionary, my start value, and I want to replace that with next value. So what I want to replace, I want to replace small a with capital A. And I am looking for any string that starts with small a. Okay, let's see. It worked. All right, it worked. It got from my small a got changed to capital A. But thing is, now I'm calling this replace method directly on my data frame. So it will try to replace value in all the columns, not only ID columns. So how do I change that thing? So let me call LOC. I need all the rows, but only one column. And now on this column, so this will basically give me a series. And on top of that, I am calling this replace method. So it got changed. So, and if I want to change this to data frame, I will just add that in the list. Yeah, so I got the data frame now. All right, and you can see this A got replaced. All right, but it did not change my original data frame because this is returning me a new object. So if you check the original data frame, it is still the same. All right, if I want to replace my original database, I need to select this column. I need to use equal, but that's fine. I mean, we are not going to do that. All right. I will delete this guy as well. And yeah, so this is my original data frame. So we just now saw how to use replace method. Now let's look at the set index. So let me close this one and I will open set index. All right, so what it says the data frame index using existing column. Okay. So this is the key, the very first argument which you have to pass. And one of the important argument is in place. Now let's look at the example which they have given here. So they are calling this set index method on data frame and they're passing the column index. So over here, the column is month is a column. And now earlier this was the default index. Now it got changed to, when they call this set index on month column or that month label index. It got assigned as an index. So I will do the same thing in my existing data frame. So what I will do, okay, dot set underscore index. So in my case as well, this is a default index. So let's assume like I want to change this default index to ID. So I will do this. Okay, now in my data frame, ID became an index. Okay, now if you see further, they have created multi-index. Okay, so they have mentioned basically two different columns. Okay, in that set index, so they have considered that as a list. So this over here, it's a scalar value, and over here they have passed, since it's a multi-index, and they need to pass two columns. They have mentioned that in a list. So I will do the same thing. So now name, we cannot assign name as an index because it's a list. So I will use salary instead. So what I will do, I will call this salary and I will put that everything in a list. Let's see what happens. All right. So now I have multi-index, ID and salary, and name is actual value. It's a column index. All right. Okay. Now one more thing I wanted to, so even if we call set index method, I will do one thing. I will keep only ID. All right. So even if we call set index method, it won't change my original data frame. What I mean is, now if I hit my original data frame, still I have this default index. So if I want to change, really change my original data frame index, how do I do that? So I will, so there is one more argument which you need to pass to this method, that is in place. So by default, this value for this argument is false. So if I change that to true, let's see what happens. Boolean equal to true. All right. So now when I call set index with in place as true, my index of my original data frame got changed. All right, so we just saw the set index method. Now let's look at reset index method. Let's see what it does or how it works. So it resets at the index. Okay, let me open this. So what it does is, so again, you will find this in place method here. And so it reset the index or level of it. So reset the index of data frame and use the default one instead. Now, this ID is not my default index. My default index was numerical index. Okay, so let's call reset index and see what happens. Okay, so this is, so now ID became a column. Okay, and this was my original index, default index. So it's a simple, very simple method. And let's check again, did it change my original data frame? It did not. So my data frame index is still the ID. So how do I change that? I just have to pass that in place as true. That will modify my original data frame. So let me pass that value in place equal to true. All right. So we are back to square. So this was the original data frame which we had. So we just saw set index and reset index. Now let's look at the drop NA. Now what drop NA means? In our data frame, as you can see, the very last record, I have null values. Okay, if I want to drop this particular null value, how do I do that? Either I need to look for that particular record, but there is very easiest way for that is using drop NA method. So let me open the documentation of it. So what it says, it removes the missing value. So even if I had few more records with null values, and if I call that drop NA method, it will remove all the null records. But there are different ways to do that. So if you check this documentation, they have given different examples. So if I call this drop NA directly, so let me go back to the documentation. The very first argument which this method accepts is axis. So 0 is the index, that is row index. And if 1 is a column index, by default, it is 0. Okay, so if I call this drop NA method, it will look for rows where I will where it will find null values. Okay, and there is another important parameter is how. So it will look for any or all, and default is any. What does that mean? Any, if any NA value are present, drop that particular row or column. And if we'll see that, we'll see the difference between that. And again, the important another attribute is in place equal to true. So if you want to change the existing data frame, you need just need to pass this in place equal to false. Otherwise, if you don't give that, by default it is in place equal to true. So if you don't specify that, by default it is false, and it will give a new object. It won't change any value in your existing data frame on which you are calling this drop any method. So what I will do, let me grab this data frame and I will simply call drop NA. Okay, now let's compare these two records. So the last record got removed. Okay, why it got removed? Because by default, the index is zero. Okay, default is zero, which is nothing but a row. So it will look for any row which has null values in it. And now in this case, only this particular record is null. Okay, not all the values in that particular row are null. Only that particular record is null. Okay, this record, entire record, has ID, valid ID and valid name, but salary is not valid. So also, I mean, that based on this how parameter, so by default it is any. So in a record, if any of the value is null, it will drop that. Now if I want to change that behavior, so how do I do that? So instead of, so I will pass this how. So let's check how they have did that. So if you see, by default it is any. Okay, instead of all, I will pass any. It will still work the same because by default it's any. So if I change that to all, let's see what happens. Okay, now it did not delete the record. Why? Because in this particular row, not all the values are null. Only one single value is null. So now it will, so all will delete only those records wherein it will find all the values as null. And if I specify any, it will delete all those records, even if it finds only one particular value as null, right? And another thing is, like, so now the row got deleted. If I want to delete a column, so let's say if I want to delete a column where it will find null values, how do I do that? By default, it looks for row. So that is nothing but the first argument, axis. So axis equal to zero. Okay, it deletes a row, but if I change this to one, so it will look for the columns. So in this case, there are three different columns, but in the salary column, it has null value. So if I call this, the salary column will get deleted. All right, it got deleted. Now let's say again, if I change that to all, it will look for all the values in that column. And since all the values are not null, it won't delete anything. Okay. Now again, if you check this original data frame, okay, I will use any. It got deleted, but my original data frame remains same because it gives the new object of data frame. Now if I want to change that behavior, I just need to pass in place equal to true. Okay, it will return none, and it will replace the value in existing data frame, but we'll not do that. That thing we have already seen. Okay, so we just saw drop NA method, how it works. All right, let's go to the copy method. Okay, let me open the documentation of it. Okay, so it makes a copy of the object indices and data. Let's open this. Now, this particular parameter is really important. What it says is, it makes a deep copy, including a copy of the data and the indices. With deep equal to false, neither indices nor the data are copied. So let's check this one. So when deep equal to false, a new object will be created without copying the calling object's data or indices. Only references to the data and indices are copied. That means it creates a reference. It's kind of a pointer. Okay. Any changes to the data of the original will be reflected in the shallow copy and vice versa. Okay. So we'll check that. How does that work? So what I will do, let's create a copy of it. So I will keep this as is. I'll use my df.copy. So by default, it is true. So it is not a shallow copy. Okay. By default, it is true. It is not a shallow copy. And what I will do, I will use new df. All right. Now, so this is my original df. And this is my new df. Now I will try to change this a, small a, to new a, capital A, in my new df. How do I do that? Okay, let me go back to my notes and I will use this. Okay, I will use this guy. Okay, so instead of my df, I will change that to new df. Okay, now let's check this. So in my new df, those two records got changed from small a to init cap to capital A. Okay, now let's check my original data frame. It's still the same, everything is small, and my new data frame got changed. So in this case, even if I change my new data frame, my original data frame remains as is. There was no change. So that's what they are saying. When you call normal, I mean by default it is true and it won't change anything. But when you call deep equal to false, we'll see that what happens now. Okay. So I will use deep equal to false. Okay, now everything is as is. So my new data frame and original data frame are same. So this is my original data frame. And I have created another copy as new df again, but with deep equal to false. Now new df is nothing but a reference as per the documentation. And we'll figure out what it is exactly. So now both are same. Now I will change the new data frame. Again, with same, these two records I will change to init cap. Okay, now let's check the new data frame again. It got changed. Now let's look at the original data frame. So earlier, my original data frame did not get changed. Now let's see here. See, my original data frame also got changed. So what are they saying? So when you give deep equal to false, okay, that creates the reference. Okay, so that's the important point I wanted to explain. So that's a shallow copy it creates. Okay. Let's go back to the last one, that is AS type. Okay. So this is the last method for this video. Now, what AS type does is it casts the pandas object to a specified D type. Okay. So if you want to cast data type of your pandas series or data frame, you need to call this AS type, and we'll see in what scenario we have to do that. So let's consider this particular case. They are changing this call one data type from earlier it was init 32 and they have changed that to init 64. Okay, now let me go back. What I will do, let's say I need to grab a salary by each ID. Okay, how do I do that? I need to do group by. I'll do the group by on ID. Okay. And I need to get a sum of salary. Right. So salary dot sum. Okay. Now I got this value. We have seen this earlier, the sum method. But now my requirement is, let's say hypothetically, this is not percentages, but consider this as percentages. And I want to append percent sign at end of it. Okay, so let's say if I call this percent method, it will fail. All right, why it will fail? Let's look at the error. So it says on function add did not contain a loop with signature matching type. So basically the data type did not match. When I tried to concatenate this string with numerical value, it failed. So if I still want to do that, how do I do that? So okay, let me do one thing. Let me check the type of it. Okay, so it is a series. And dot info, let's say. No, info won't work. Okay, let's see. So yeah, so over here it's saying like for first column, the ID column, it is a name and the D type is float 64. Okay, so this is nothing but a float value. Okay, now let's change that to string, because if I need to concatenate percent sign, both the arguments has to be string. Okay, so that's why I need to change that to str. Now it changed that to object. So let me copy this guy here and so as you can see, earlier it was float, and moment I changed the S type to string, it got changed to object. Now let's try to append percent sign to it. Yeah, it worked. Okay, so like if there are such cases like wherein you need to append something or you need to change integer to float or something like that, you need to call this S type method, so which will basically change the data type of your series or of that particular column. All right, so thank you for watching this video, and from next video onwards we are going to explore our original ask, which was like analysis on Airbnb dataset of New York City. Thank you for watching this video.